Right, we're back once again, and up to this point, we've actually accomplished quite a bit. If we just do a really quick playtest, we've got a character that we can move and rotate. He can shoot his weapon. We have an enemy that will chase him down, but right now, our projectiles don't really do anything. What we want is for them to damage the enemy and then eventually destroy him. So that's what we're going to do in this video. We're going to set up that damaging behavior between the projectiles and the enemy. To start this off, we're going to begin inside the enemy character class. We need to basically expose the ability to transfer damage, to talk to that health value that we set up in C++. Because we actually did two things in C++, if you recall. We set up these variables, and then we also created the calculate health function, which is really just going to take in an incoming delta, add it to the existing health, and then store whatever that new value is as the new health, which is great. What we need, though, is a way to talk between blueprints. The projectile is one blueprint, the enemy is another, and we need a way to communicate in between them. And the way we do that communication, or one of the ways in which we can do that communication, is with an interface. So we're going to make a blueprint interface and use that to communicate with that calculate health function that we set up in C++. So to set this up, actually, before we set anything up, let me kind of describe, I guess in general terms, what an interface is. An interface is a collection of unimplemented functionality. That sounds like that's really a programmery way to explain it. So let me think of a different way to say it. If I have two people in front of me, we'll say Bob and Tom. So we have these two characters, Bob and Tom. And if I tell Bob to tell me a story, Bob might tell me about how he walked home last night and stopped by the grocery store and bought something for dinner. But if I tell Tom to tell me a story, he might tell me about something he did last weekend. Maybe he went camping. Maybe he... the point is, he did something totally different than Bob is. They both had two different results that they gave back to me, even though I gave them the same command. I both just told them, tell me a story. Well, an interface is how you set up those generic commands, like tell me a story. And then within each receiving thing, within each thing that knows what that command is, you can make it define what that really means. If that's confusing in any way, just watch and we'll make it all make sense. So let's start by building our interface. We're gonna right click and go under the blueprint submenu, and there it is, blueprint interface. So click, and we're gonna call this lowercase i, short for interface, damageable. That is a common code naming convention for interfaces. So I damageable, we're gonna double click it. Now we have, what it has here is a function that will have no implementation. Basically, it's like kind of declaring that we're gonna do something with this given name, but we don't really know what yet. And what we're gonna name this function is affect health. Now, affect health is gonna need to take in some value, some numeric value that we can use to affect our health by some amount. So under the input section down here in the details panel, it is in the details panel, excuse me. Click on the new button and let's set this to a name of delta. There you go. And then take its type and set it to a float. That's it, that's all we have to do. Notice we can't even connect any nodes to this because it's all grayed out. The purpose of an interface is that you just define the structure for what functionality you want, and then you define what that functionality is within any object that implements that interface. So the function could mean different things to different classes. So let's compile and save this, and then we're actually done with iDamageable. We don't have to do anything else to it. We can close it. However, we need to make sure that our enemy character implements iDamageable. Now, another fun fact, just kind of introducing you to some of the concepts of working with interfaces. Any class in your game can talk to this interface now. So like right now, I could say affect health, and there it is, an interface message. So he can send out a call through the interface to talk to other things. He doesn't have to have anything special to do that. The interface just has to exist. But if he needs to receive data or receive some sort of call from the interface, then he must implement that interface. And here's how you do that. If you go under your class settings, not class defaults, class settings, there's a section here called interfaces, and there's implemented interfaces. Right now, none are implemented. So click the add button, and from the dropdown, you'll see iDamageable. Click on that, and there you go. That's it, that's all you have to do. Make sure you compile and save once you've done that. Now when you right click, check it out. If you type affect health, there is now an event for it. So this event will be fired whenever any other blueprint calls affect health on this object. So now you've basically just created a pathway where other blueprints can talk to this guy. Now what's gonna happen when we call this? This is where our C++ code becomes handy. We can drag a wire out from this and just say, calculate health. So we've affected it from some outside source. Now let's calculate and get our new result. And delta just plugs right into delta. That's it. Now, let's talk about what happens when this guy dies. So remember, calculate health is going to take an incoming delta, it's gonna add that to the existing health and then store that as the new health. So if the value is negative 20, the new result will be 80 because it's counting down. And then it's going to run that little helper function we set up called calculate dead. And calculate dead just simply says, hey, did health make it to zero or less yet? Because if it did, then set is dead to true. If it hasn't yet, leave is dead at false. That's great, because what that means is we can grab is dead and notice something. Do you remember, actually, I'm gonna open it up and show you. Watch this, this is pretty awesome. If we open up our base character class, which is gonna open up Visual Studio, we'll let it do its thing. Thank you, prepare solutions. Haha, we're back. That was nice and fast. If you remember, so there's calculate dead, and you can see it's just checking to see if something's dead or not, and it's setting the value. But if we take a look when we declared the isDead Boolean property, we had those keywords, right? Blueprint read only. It's not blueprint read write. We can actually verify that. Check this out. If I close out of Visual Studio, just because we don't need it anymore, let's go back over to Unreal, and we go inside our enemy character, look at this. If I drag isDead into the world, notice that set is grayed out. I cannot set. That is because this is read only. But I can get it, which is all I need to do. I just wanted to point that out, that those keywords were actually doing cool stuff. So now we can take isDead and let's test it. So we'll do a branch. And if isDead tests out to be true, then let's destroy this actor. So the enemy will just cease to exist because that's how destruction tends to work. Now let's, just for debugging purposes, I'm gonna set up some temporary quote unquote code here. As soon as we calculate health, I want to get our health and I wanna print it out to the screen. So let's do print string and we'll connect this into the line. Now notice this takes in a string and health is a float value. If I try to connect them, Unreal is like, oh, you don't know the difference between a float and a string. That's fine, don't worry, I'll convert them for you. So cool, what this means is we will get a message from some outside source. Spoiler alert, it's gonna be from the laser. The laser is gonna call this. We will calculate our health. We'll print out whatever our new health happens to be, then we'll check and see if the character is dead. If it turns out they did die, then we're just gonna destroy them and they'll just disappear. So let's compile and save. Now, this won't do anything just yet. We have to tell the projectile that it can talk to the enemy by way of the interface. And here's how we're gonna set that up. So if we take a look at our projectile, we have this nice collision sphere. We're gonna use this to our advantage. So let's start off by grabbing, here in our event graph, we're gonna begin with event actor begin overlap. An overlap is what happens when two actors' components are intersecting the same space. So basically that collision sphere we set up, if that's overlapping something, then we're gonna get this event call. Also, it's a good idea to double check your collision settings. So let's click on our projectile collision. This is currently set to overlap all dynamic. I'm kind of okay with that, but since we're only ever shooting at pawns, let's set this to overlap only pawn. It'll probably work better in the long run. So compile and save. Now, back over here in the event graph, as soon as we detect an overlap, what's gonna happen? Well, we have access to the other actor. This is the other thing that we just overlapped with. So check this out. We can check to see if it implements a given interface. Does it, yes or no? And the interface we wanna look for, obviously, is iDamageable. So I just held down the B key and clicked, and that created a branch node. Super useful shortcut. Once again, I'll show you. Hold down B, click, you get a branch. And we'll connect that up. So we just tested to see if whatever we just hit, or whatever we just overlapped with, implements the iDamageable interface. Awesome. Now, if it does, we could just damage the whatever it is we hit, right? And that would work just fine. But one extra spoiler, depending on how you set up your arrow component where you're shooting, depending on where your gun is placed, it is possible in extreme circumstances that you could end up colliding with, overlapping the player. In effect, it's kind of like saying you have the ability for the player to shoot himself. Or, put another way, you could shoot other hero characters if you modified this game to be multiplayer. So what I'd like to do is establish a system where we then check to see if we just overlap with the player. And if we overlap with the player, we're not going to do anything. So how do we, because at the end of the day, the reason I'm checking for this is the player will eventually also implement iDamageable. He doesn't right now, but he would test true at this point. So we need to verify we didn't actually hit him. Here's how we're going to do it. Let's go to the hero character class. So here we are in the hero. Let's go over to the event graph, and we're going to select his class default properties, not settings, his defaults. And over in the details panel at the very bottom, there's this actor category. Expand that, and there's this little hidden property called tags. Tags are just like tags on a whole lot of different internet activities, right? They're just the ability to put some sort of name in place that could mean anything. So let's hit the little plus B, let's add a new tag, and let's call this friendly. Awesome, so we have a tag named friendly, so now we can look for that tag. Let's compile and save, and then over here in our projectile, we can take the other actor. Now I'm gonna use reroute nodes just so it's easy for you to see what we're doing. We can say has tag, and look, there's a node for that, actor has tag. Now what tag are we looking for? Obviously we're looking for friendly. Now that just reports out a Boolean value. Did it find the tag, yes or no? So let's do another branch, hold down B and click. So if this tested true, let's then test and see if he's got the tag. Now here's the deal. Whenever I get the result that I want out of a branch, I would rather that result be true. Basically, I would like all of my tests to return true if they can. So we're gonna take actor has tag, and we're actually going to attach that to a not node. So it's kind of inverting it. If you read this out in plain English, it would say, hey, does this object not have the friendly tag, which is a little different than how you'd actually say that, because turns out you can say that in common everyday English speak, which is kind of annoying. Okay, so we check and see if they do not have the tag. We make sure they don't have the tag. And if they don't have the tag, then finally we can affect their health. So let's do another reroute node. Now, to make sure that we're calling affect health on the right object, let's just do it this way. Let's just say affect health, like so. Now, that is asking for a delta, right? How much you're affecting the health. Let's set this to negative 20. Remember, our C++ code is adding the values together. So if we want to decrement health, we need to set this to a negative number. Okay, so we've done that, but let's make this into a variable. So I'm going to take delta, I'm going to right-click on it, and promote that to a variable. And we'll call this damage. Cool, now that's being stored. Now, pretty much no matter what happens, I want us to destroy this laser or this projectile when we're done. So make a destroy actor node, and after we've affected health, we want to destroy the actor. If we hit something that did not implement the interface, also destroy the actor. But if we hit something and it turned out to be the player, we're going to do nothing. So we'll leave false disconnected. And I'll use some reroute nodes to make this a little bit cleaner. Okay, so if you need to see that whole network again, let's stretch this out just a little bit. I'll try to condense things down as best I can so we can fit them all on the screen for just a moment. Bear with me. Bear with me. There we go. And then pull this in. So there you go. So begin overlap. Check and see if it implements the interface. If it does, check and make sure that it doesn't have the friendly tag. And if that's true, meaning it doesn't have the friendly tag, then let's go ahead and affect its health. All right, awesome. So let's compile and save. Let's come out here to our map. Let me hit Control S to save everything. Let's hit play. And here he is. Oh, check it out. Did you see his health dropping? It counted all the way down to 20, just like that. Hit him again, and he's gone. Boom, so we got it. We're doing damage to the enemy. Now that we've confirmed that, however, just to be on the nice and neat side, let's go into our enemy and let's remove this little portion of the graph that is reporting that out. We don't really need it. We know it's working. So compile, save, play one more time. And now we shoot. After 5 shots, the enemy goes away, which is perfect. So we have the ability to damage the enemy. That's great. That is going to wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.